Hi. Now, let's look at adding admin views and site views to Component Builder's component and looking at all the different switches and the nice features that we have there installed for you. So, we'll first log in here. Then we have Component Builder open under Component Builder. And then we'll go to, let's see, Components. And we will open Sermon Distributor and then go to Settings, and in Settings you see there is a place for admin views. We've already illustrated adding the admin views. Then there's custom admin views and there's site views, and we want to look at those now. So I'll just click on Add Custom Admin View. There isn't any added to this component because Component Builder, sorry, Sermon Distributor does not have a custom admin views, but I'll illustrate it in another component for you. Then site views, it has quite a few. You might sometimes open it and see that some of the buttons are not selected, although you know you selected it previously and saved, and you know now it doesn't show. This is a glitch in Joomla's own JavaScript or whatever that is causing this, and so the only way I have found to solve it as yet is to simply reopen. Like for now, you see the admin view, it has the same issue. So if you close it and open it again, it has it all selected. This is a heads up, you know, keep a lookout for this, because if you make changes and save it with those buttons unticked, your build will not include those values, for since it will be stored as null, and you might get unexpected results. So always make sure that your all ticks are all in place. That's just a heads up. It's not really something I can change at this stage. It's a Joomla thing of the repeatable fields. Okay, so if we go to site view and we just close it again and open it again, you see everything is selected. You see that it has 1, 2, 3, 4 options here. Obviously here you select the site views, just add as many as you like. Then add menu means that this site view will be added to the add menu aspect of Joomla. You know, if you go to create menu and then you go to add menu item, then there is a select type, and when you clicked on select type, then there's this list, articles and whatever. Now if you say yes there, it'll create a XML file which allows Joomla to notice that your component needs to be in the list. And the XML file, we'll look at it in a moment, but that's just that you know that's what this switch here add menu does. Add metadata means that this page is gonna actually make use of the metadata that is being passed to it. Usually that means that in your model you've set up your data so that there is a metadata in the items array, or in the item array, or in the this array, either via the global setting or via the actual item. So this meta implementation, you even if you said yes here and you did not set up the data in the model correctly, it won't work. And the way for you to look at that is obviously click yes here, try your best setting up the data in the model, then compile and go look in the view.html.php file to see how it grabs the metadata, because it will still add the script that is needed to load the metadata into the document. But if it doesn't grab it correctly, then you'd see that as well. Okay, then whether you can only have one default view, so don't click more than one to yes. But what the default view effectively is that sometimes when you make a change and the system doesn't know where you want to go, it actually throws you back to the default view. Now that default view could either be your site's default view, being a home page, or it can be, if you're in this component, it could be, for example, in this one, it's preachers. So let's say some of these views you set that they don't, that this user, a public user, don't have access, for example, to sermon. Then if they try to access that page, the system will throw them back to the default view and give them a message saying you don't have access. And so that's what the default view primarily is used for at the moment. But I can see it becoming even more useful as we continue improving Component Builder. Then add access is basically making sure that a certain user has the specific access rights. You see, in a in an item, you can set the access rights as well as the view rights. So it's multiple implementations, different implementations. One is access groups, the other one is just groups. And so you can tweak whether you want access on this specific view to be monitored. And if you tick that, then Component Builder will ensure that the access table is there. Okay, so that is adding a site view to your component. Obviously, after having created the site view, then this is how you can add it to check it and see how it works. Okay, now next up, we're going to look at custom admin views being added. Thank you for watching.